Jean, this is a practical guide what to do with your parents as they age. When did you first realise that we really needed to start talking about this stuff?
Well, I suppose when I started trying to help my parents as they age, you know, keep them safe and happy and have a meaningful life, and I was trying to help them, and it was very fraught. My mum's 95 now and my dad's 93. He's her toy boy. and I've been trying to look after them since, like, Dad was 75 and first got on the roof to clean the gutters and, you know, and his hips were about 60 years younger than he was. And I was like, get off the roof. So, you know, I've been very tense about it and I didn't know how to make the right decisions. Those decisions are really important because if you make the wrong decision, you can affect your parents' happiness, their health, their safety, everything.
How were they about it? Often, like, one wants to go into it. Yeah, one's happy to kind of go into a home or whatever we call it, and the others are more resistant. Were they both want to go in? Or?
Well, no, they're not in a home now. They're still living independently in a retirement village.
Right.
But they get a lot of home care. So even working out how to access care and get them assessed and how to have people come in and help them, they're very resistant, my parents.
I assume the aim of the book was to work out how to put them in a home.
Well, if you want to put them in a home, there's 200 questions you need to ask that are in those books to find the right home.
Great. It's such a timely book. I'm actually part of a WhatsApp group with a whole lot of friends who are dealing with various issues with their older parents. But I find it really interesting because I feel like it's happening earlier that we're dealing with issues with our parents, but still while we have really little kids as well. Mm. So we're almost in the middle trying to work out how to do both at the same time. It's incredibly stressful.
It's really stressful. This is a sandwich generation, so our kids are staying home longer and longer and we're still working. And then we've got elderly parents who need our care, you know. So I built a granny flat, but underneath the house, which had 23 steps, and all my friends are going, a granny flat with steps, I'm saying, but they're so nimble. And then, you know, next thing, they're both on frames, there's frame rage in the house, but also, well, they live in it, they just looked at the granny flat and said, we're not moving in there. But I think having an app, like having these private conversations is a good idea, and a lot of siblings and families do that. Well, our parents used to talk about us behind our back, so, you know.
What are the hardest issues to talk about with your parents?
Well, I think their mental health, how they're feeling, is very hard. End of life, you know, your advanced directives, the end of life care plan is really hard. You've got to get in early because this is like the youngest you or your parents will ever be, so don't put it off. You need to talk about what makes their life have meaning at the end and how. Look, if they keep going and the way medicine is, they may end up in hospital and then you have to make these really tough decisions about medical treatment. So with my mum, she had a stroke and we hadn't had this discussion. We ended up talking about her end of life, her advanced directive, what she wanted. Did she want antibiotics? Did she want the machine turned off? What machine was it? Not the iron, I don't think. But, you know, like, and we ended up having it at 100 decibels in a ward with all these other elderly women. Everyone was traumatised because mum's deaf. So, you know, I had to go through this form. So I think there's a lot of difficult conversations.
Jean, it's interesting you mentioned that with medicine, we are living longer and longer, which is great, but it also means that we're having more and more problems as we get into our old age. Are we, and this question cannot sound sensitive, but are we at the point where we don't actually want to keep living longer and longer?
Well, no, I don't think so. I don't think we're at that point.
Yeah.
Everyone would, if you're well and you're happy and your life has meaning and you're still connected to family, of course you want to
live. And what about if you
keep... He's only like 36 years old. That's why he's asking.
He's wondering about when do we turn off the machine.
First I thought I could put them in a home, now I thought I could get rid of them.
Yeah, now they're just going to go on and on. Exactly. Right. Yeah, it is harder, but, you know, medicine is great. My mum's on 9 meds, you know, so she couldn't get into a music festival.
Jean's book is We Need to Talk About Mum and Dad. It is out now. Ladies and gentlemen, Jean Kittson.